sliders.
Baby, don't come with other excuses when you should
Bitch, it's not an excuse.
I declined again.
Watch him slide it and it's gonna work. Don't try. You're gonna delete that part of the vlog.
Oh, no. You should got declined.
Fuck you.
Moving on with Scott. I'm so excited.
Scott. Can I come in? We're gonna watch it. Hey, Scott. Hi, Kristen. I thought we were gonna, you know, watch a movie out in the living room. You like have boys' night, you know, the Netflix it up, some beer, popcorn, you know, just.
I know we were going to.
We're watching something right now.
She has to like talk for you. Like we can't even have a conversation right now.
Can you pause it before? Like you're fucking interrupting this.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Is that what we do now? Like we literally planned this like for 2 days now. Like we were gonna have boys' night tonight. You know, Sunday night. Like. Everybody works tomorrow.
She's off work on the weekend, so it's like the only time we can hang out, you know? So I figured like I should watch a movie with her tonight.
She's here every day.
I'm here right now. I can hear you talking.
Oh, okay, well, I'll just, that's cool. I'll just go. Well, it doesn't look like I'm your roommate. It looks more like I'm an acquaintance or something.
Well, you're an annoyance right now, Zane. We're fucking watching.
You know, I'm gonna go watch the movie by myself that we plan to watch on Netflix with popcorn and beer. So,
I'm
sorry, Zane.
Okay, whatever.
Ooh, it's coffee time with Zane and Heath.
You know what I mean? But no, it was cool. Baby got to hold a Glock again, felt so good.
Alright, so what's up with these clown sightings here?
Everybody's freaking out about it. I don't understand it.
Okay, so, but it was a long time ago.
I haven't heard anything on the news about it, but like apparently people are dressing like clowns and killing people.
No, it's not killing people. Remember there was clown sightings a long time ago, and then now it's like coming back as a trend?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But these videos are like so fake, they just look so staged.
Like they're acting like they're gonna be like, these,
and then friends will pretend that they ran into like a clown. Dumbass kids think they can stage this shit. We've been on the internet for a very long time.
Okay, you ain't YouTubers!
Go,
shit! I just got my sandwich!
Dirty, rotten pig ass.
Got a box for my roommates and they bitches.
Pete, baby, this is where they got your send help.
Oh, bitch, I know. I'm looking for the dude that fucking did it. He gonna catch a fade real quick. He gonna catch a...
What are you getting done here?
Probably nothing.
You said you're gonna get a piercing.
I don't trust none of these bitches.
You're gonna get a piercing. You told me that. Don't lie to me. You said you're gonna get your left nut pierced.
I'll get tattooed anything on my body, wherever you want. If you can tell me I'll put a fucking penis on my forehead.
It'd been really dope if I knew who sung this, but I don't.
What's embarrassing is that you don't know who sings the song.
Oh, man, he's getting his first piercing.
You're the one who sent, like, David Dobrik's brother. That's your fault, motherfucker. Engagement just dropped to zero.
You look sexy.
I hate it.
Too stupid.
Yeah, I know, bitch.
Okay, so Zane and I went to the gas station to get some beer. While we were there, a guy in line says, hey, do you guys have international calling on your phone? And I was like, no, but my girlfriend does. And he goes, well, I found this wallet, and inside are these two IDs from these two people from the United Kingdom, I guess out on a vacation. So he gives it to us, and he has a phone number, and he goes, call it. So we get back home, we try to call it, the number doesn't work. We get on Facebook and try to find them, and we find them.
At this point, we're like, we don't know who these people are. These people could be like out here doing sketchy shit.
This guy who gave us the wallet could have like murdered them, and now our DNA is all over the wallet.
We go to the alley to try to find this dead body, and we're like, me and Matt are like on a fucking adventure trying to figure this shit out.
And so I get on Facebook Messenger and I try to call her because there's that call option. It doesn't even like ring twice or three times and like let you know it's a voicemail. And so we're sitting there and I'm like, and I wish we had the audio.
As we're trying to figure it out, we're all on Twitter or Facebook to try to find them and like contact them. And he holds onto the voice memo thing on Facebook on accident and you just hear us.
And so you hear us like he's like, we gonna figure this shit out.
Are they missing? Do you see anything on their wall? We gonna figure this shit out. Solve this mystery.
Or we're getting ourselves into a...
Right. If they come here, they're fucking squatted up.
No, what I'm saying is, like, we've been watching those murders.
All being recorded on the voicemail, and then it sends to them.
And I click send and I just see that this voice memo from us has gone to them. And we're like, oh my God, these people are gonna like freak out when they get this. Or we're gonna be in court one day and we're gonna be sitting there. And the judge would be like, well, let's listen to this voice recording you sent them.
It's Nancy.
Oh, Fox News on Nancy Grace. 3 internet stars apparently murdered 2 beautiful young couple from the United Kingdom out on a vacation. Let's listen to the voicemail.
They're playing the voicemail to everyone in the courtroom, and me and Matt have to just sit there and all
so
this.
So insensitive, these young boys, to murder this couple in cold blood.
These two kids are just making fun of a dead body in an alleyway. Are these kids really internet stars?
It only makes sense. They're psychopaths, online and in real life. This is what the people do.
Nancy takes it from here to fucking...
God, we become the new Making a Murderer. We have our own Netflix, like, documentary.
I was saying me and Matt start vlogging, trying to solve this mystery. And it's on my YouTube channel, Zane and Matt. And I'm vlogging everything. People just think this is a fake skit show, but, like, we're actually trying to figure it out. Cops are seeing these YouTube videos. Shit is happening in the back as we're recording, and people are pausing it and putting red circles and putting it on Twitter.
Put all of our, like, lines backwards and says that we, like, confess to the murder and everything. So we wanted to give them the wallet, but we thought we were going to leave and we weren't going to be able to give it to them, so we put it in our mailbox. And he actually just messaged me and said that he put a reward and said it's, you know, something for you and your girl to get a few drinks. It's like a coupon, like it's a $5 Starbucks gift card.
It's a stripper card that he had in his wallet.
Meet Patty down at Gold Diggers. You'll have a good time.
All right, well, let's figure this shit out.
Let's hope it's not like ticking or anything.
There's a timer like, going down to 7:65. It's like, ooh, the reward opens in 7 seconds.
It's like a glitter bomb or like just silly string. It goes like, there's a wire.
Ooh!
Got us some money.
Supposedly this guy had like $200 in his wallet, and it was so awkward for Matt to have to tell him that there was no cash in the wallet. This guy just thinks now you have $200. He's like, you know, I'm gonna give him $30 just in case he has the $200. I don't want to give him too much extra.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it. And subscribe to my channel if you want to see more stuff from me and all my friends. Like David over here sleeping. You see, that wasn't so bad, was it?
Shit, that was so easy. I did that shit with my eyes closed. That thing, fine as hell. Thick as fuck, oh my
God. That's my baby. Ooh, he drinking coffee too.
He's part of the squad.